Everyone wants to be productive. If you're working 8 hours a day, you want those hours to be as useful as possible. But being productive isn't always easy. If it was, life would be a breeze. Productivity comes and goes in waves, and sometimes doesn't happen at all. I'm Nate, and today we're going to be talking about the Pareto Principle and how it can help your productivity. The Pareto Principle, also called the 80-20 rule, is named after the esteemed economist Vilfredo Pareto, who happened to love Alfredo and played with Plato. Anyway, he examined Italian land and investigated the relationship between wealth and population, eventually discovering that 80% of the land in Italy was owned by 20% of the population. He later discovered that the same rule applied to other countries. Fast forward a little bit, and other smart people start to realize that this applied to many areas in life, like a lot of areas. Here's some examples just to name a few. 20% of employees are responsible for 80% of the results. 20% of criminals commit 80% of the crimes. 20% of products represent 80% of sales. And 80% of all pollution originates from 20% of all the factories. And the list goes on. By definition, the Pareto Principle states that for many outcomes, roughly 80% of consequences come from just 20% of the causes. So why is this relevant? Well, the Pareto Principle can be applied to many areas in life. An example is time management. If you're able to find 20% of the work that drives 80% of your outcomes, you can start focusing on that specific work and then skyrocket your productivity. So how do we do it? Finding the 20%. Finding the 20% means learning what the most important work is. This means analyzing your workload. It can be difficult if you balance lots of tasks at once. So ask yourself, what are you getting paid to do? Do you have any obstacles? Are you regularly prioritizing important work over urgent work? Do you wish you had more time for certain tasks? If it's freelance or project-based, what work gives you the best return? When a lot of people ask themselves these questions, they realize that they're spending too much time on work that isn't really their job description. A simple example would be a call center manager might be spending too long on simple administration tasks, instead of getting the best out of their workers and implementing skill-based routing. As for freelancers, they may find that they often prioritize work that doesn't pay as well over work that does. And here's where Pareto comes into play. 20% of their work is creating 80% of their return. Applying the Pareto Principle to your productivity. Doing the hard task first. Who wants to work hard? Working hard sucks, right? Well, not really. Not if you embrace it head on. Working on that tough stuff first before all your other simple work can help most of the time. If you do this, it won't be on your mind throughout the day, and you won't feel under pressure and stressed until it's done. You also know how much time you have left to do the easy tasks. If you do the easy tasks first, you might not have enough time to do the hard work later, and then it'll be too late and you'll put it off till tomorrow. Of course, there is exceptions, like when you're feeling very unmotivated. Getting some small tasks done first can be used as sort of accomplishment leverage. You can use this to get going and build up productivity momentum. Identifying distractions. What's distracting to you the most? YouTube, friends, colleagues, some TikTok on how to make gorgonzola stuffed Tex-Mex beef enchiladas? I'm hungry just from saying that. The Pareto Principle can help eliminate distractions when you're working. If you know you need to complete your 20%, you can work hard and do that, and then use your distractions as a reward. Once you completed that hard task, you can finish that video, talk to whoever, or go back on Instagram for your daily thumb exercises. But first, you gotta finish your work. Finding aids. Once you've established the 20%, you can find ways to help you with the less important tasks, making them take up even less time. This might be project management tools or software. For example, contact center as a service is great for in-call centers, as it improves customer satisfaction with no extra effort from call center employees. This allows them to focus on that 20% even when they're doing remote work. Freelancers can benefit from this too. A freelancer often spends a lot of time on personal admin, like sending invoices or calculating fees. If they can start using automation software, like marketing automation platforms, they'll be able to focus on that 20% and get way faster revenue. Applying the Pareto Principle to your well-being. Yes, productivity and well-being go hand in hand. Isn't that surprising? When we're happy, it's a lot easier to be productive. And when we're feeling down, it's a lot harder to be productive. So how can Mr. Pareto help us with this dilemma? Generally, we don't spend all of our time doing things that make us happy. Unless you're like Bugs Bunny or Charlie Sheen. And that's okay. It's normal to have a few work tasks that you don't enjoy. Pareto and the 80-20 rule can be used to help you determine how you feel about your job. If you notice that it's more than 20% of your work that you dread doing, it might be that work is dictating your unhappiness. While there are ways to take away stresses of a role, if you continue to feel unhappy about that work, it may be time for a change. Here's some examples of areas in your life where you can use the Pareto principle to improve wellness. Exercise. Once you determine the 20% of workouts that give the best results, you can focus more attention on them. Clean your closet. Most people wear only 20% of the clothing that's in their closet. Having your closet cleared out and getting rid of the things you don't wear will help create space and increase wellness. Change your television and internet habits. Nowadays, most people spend a lot of time just watching screens. How many times do you watch a show that actually excites you? Really? Pareto would say it's probably only 20% of the time. Cutting out meaningless TV and mindless social media scrolling will give you more time for activities and goals you actually care about. Using the Pareto principle can be difficult at first, but it's all about analyzing what you're doing and using a business mind to establish where your best results come from. It can be applied in all areas of your life to improve productivity and wellness. So take your time and try applying the Pareto principle to your life. Thanks for watching our video. Check out some of the other ones, and we'll see you next time.